Hi, the Dallas Film Festival wants to welcome the director and producer from the film Versa. Thank you guys for coming. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us.
You're welcome. I understand that it's a true story. Tell us a little bit about it.
See, this is a true story about a old man called Jogendra Singh, which I put a name in the film also. I see a lot in the West that the Asian families, where their son, their children doesn't behave good with the old men's, their old guys. So this is a true story where we show he's working there in the restaurant. They don't behave very good with them. So this is about the emotion and about the culture of the film.
Now, and how did you guys meet?
Well, I was introduced to Mr. Batra in Mumbai, or Bombay, we call here. I was in the process of visiting some friends, and they were recording some. I write some music and songs, especially not music songs. And we were discussing that, but then subject came up that need to make a movie. And I had traveled to India, just not maybe about a year before that, and went to see the place where I was born, a small village called Jacobpur, which is about like 200 families live there. Went there, and the reception I got was so emotional and so exceptional. The whole village came out, they were all dancing, Bhangra, and they were playing drums. They took me to their houses, each of them wanted me to eat in their house, showed me the where I may have been born and showed me the place where my uncles lived. So, and it was such an experience that I felt connected to the, my roots, where I was born. I became more realized that what it means to be involved with your background. And Virsa means really heritage, or means your tradition. It is very all-encompassing word in a way. But so then I was in Bombay visiting, and then I was introduced to Pankaj, and he had a very good story. I was introduced to him because we were talking about possibly making a movie. And he had a very compelling story that he brought. And I being emotionally, just having had that emotional experience in Jacobpur, that's the village, I felt connected. We read the story time and again, and we talked about that, went through the whole process, and finally we said, yes, we'd make this movie.
Oh, wow. Well, that's fantastic.
Yeah.
When he was so receptive to producing the movie with you,
yeah.
Tell us about that experience, because I know that that is just unbelievable to have somebody kind of capture the same vision that you have.
See, it's a dream come true, A producer like Dr. Saab, no tensions in the set, never say anything, just go with the script, whatever the script demands. He always go through it. Don't worry, do it. Don't take tension at all. So it's a very dream come true to work with Dr. Amanullah Khan.
Oh, well, it's beautifully pictured. I mean, just the colors. I was looking at some of the stills and everything. It's
Yeah.
just beautiful. I understand that you shot it in Australia,
Yeah.
did all the post in India, and so tell us about the experience, because not only do you have a message of bringing together different cultures, tying in the roots. Not only did you have that in your message, but you also had it on set with having different cast and crew from all over, as well as in the post-production and filming it. So tell us a little bit about how that came together.
See, because script demands to work with the different sort of actors from the different sort of countries. We work from the actors from Australia. We'll take actors from Australia also. We'll take some actors from Pakistan also. Our main lead, Marine Ryle, is from Pakistan. Numan Ijaz is from Pakistan. Then we have A-grade actor like Gulshan Grover. West knows him. He done some lot of work in West also. Arya Babbar is a hero of our film. So they all are from the different countries, different background. And it's a challenging, and it's tough to be unite them on the set, because they don't they have very different cultures, so different roots. They have very different way to work together. But at last, I only say that it's a teamwork, and we get a very, very nice result.
I can add something to
Oh,
that, if I
please.
may.
Yeah, please do.
This is an area which is strife-torn. You're aware of that, what's going on in that part of the world. To have a team which is from opposing parties and thing from Pakistan, from India, and then have them in Australia setting, and have a director like him, it's not easy to put it all together.
Mm-hmm.
So he had a very unique ability also that was sort of brought a group together, make a team out of it, and have them all work in a very congenial manner. And the movie shows, the product shows how well they work together.
I'm sure that's very rewarding to be able to step back and look at that from a producer standpoint, to be able to see everything and all the pieces, and especially from a director to see the creativity and everything behind that. Speak to what it was like developing the storyline. You know, I understand here that you have an appreciation of these people. What was it about these people that struck you, that you wanted to spread a message about, you know, bringing cultures together and adapting the culture that you're in currently to your roots? What was it about those people that kind of struck that chord in you?
See, I think there is no, you know, they all are professional, then they do. The one thing which I'm happy about all of them is that they all have a very good and very hard conviction about the script, about the characters. And I just told them one thing: you only follow your character, you only follow the graph of your character, and we'll get the result. And this happened, you know. Everybody work on their character, and at last we get a very good result.
Now, but specifically about this people, you know, you talked about their appreciation, their generosity, their kindness. Is that, are those some of the things, the elements that you wanted to convey in your message? Or is there a certain type of character, as you were saying, you know, I know that there is one in the script that you're talking specifically about, but how did you take that spark of understanding this people and want to convey that in your message?
Again, I'm telling you, it's we done some kind of workshops first to start the film, because I believe, you know, okay, actors should be very comfortable. Every actor should be very comfortable to each other when they start working. So I'll put a one workshop in India for a kind of 7-8 days, and we start them to, you know, sharing their ideas to each other, what they think about, because they all act very different way, because they are coming from the different countries and different styling. So when they share their ideas with each other, and when they make a kind of comfort zone with each other, which works for me very well.
Yeah, I'm sure it does.
Yeah.
Now you are here in Dallas, so to have a film, you know, of this caliber in your home city, how wonderful is that, to enjoy that?
I'm enjoying this. This is wonderful in that something comes right to my own city where I have friends and they can enjoy to participate in my joy and happiness. And also I know that we'll get a tremendous support from the local people. I have had nothing but emails and phone calls and messages that they all want to come and see it. In fact, we don't have enough tickets for tonight. I don't know, I may have some enemies there too. No, not really. Some unhappy people who may not be able to come in tomorrow.
Oh, well, we certainly do appreciate you guys being here, and thank you so much for your wonderful film. So,
thank you. Thank you very much.
Absolutely.
Appreciate it. Thanks.